You are welcome to this channel. So far in this fourth chapter we have seen how to draw the graph of sine, cos, tangent function and their inverses, okay? And also we have seen the exercises 4.1, 4.2 and 4.3. Now in this video we are going to see how to draw the graph of secant and cosecant and their inverses, okay? To start with, let us see the how to draw the graph of cosecant function. Okay, you know that cosecant x is nothing but the reciprocal of sine x. So what would be the domain of the cosecant function? Already I have explained how to find out the domain and range. Once again, let me repeat it. Okay, so how to find out the domain of this cosecant function? So what would be the value of x which can be given to the which can be given such that the cosecant x exists? Okay, as it is a reciprocal of sine x, we have to give the value of x in such a way that sine x should not be equal to 0. So for the values of x, sine x is equal to 0, cosecant x does not exist. So for what value of x sine x does not exist? You know that sine pi equal to 0, then sine 2 pi equal to 0, sine 0 is also equal to 0, and sine 3 pi is equal to 0, etc. And therefore, sine of, we can say that sine of n pi is equal to 0 for all n belongs to z, if angles are measured in the positive direction. If angles are measured in the negative direction, that is in the clockwise direction, sine minus pi, sine of minus 2 pi, sine of minus 3 pi is also 0. And therefore, we can have sine of n pi is equal to 0 for n belongs to z. Therefore, for these values, for these angles n pi, sine value will be 0. So, to get the cosecant x, to get the value of cosecant x, you have to exclude that values of n pi from the entire real number r. Okay, so what should be the value of x given in order to get the cosecant x? R minus n pi, n belongs to z. That means excluding the values of n pi for which sine x is equal to 0, the remaining for the remaining values cosecant x exists. Therefore, the domain of cosecant x is r minus n pi, n belongs to z, right? Now, what would be the range of this cosecant x means? For to get the range of x, let us give some values of x for one complete revolution and then let us find the corresponding cosecant x value, okay? So, for x is equal to 0, what would be the cosecant x? 1 by sine 0. Sine 0 is 0, so 1 by 0 means it is infinity, right? And then for 30 degree, that is for pi by 6 radians, sine pi by 6 is sine 30 is 1 by 2. So, cosecant x will be 1 by 1 by 2, that is 2. So, cosecant x would be 2. And then for sine 90, that is for pi by 2 radians, sine 90 is 1 and hence cosecant 90 will be 1. Reciprocal of 1 is also 1. Then, these are the angles in the first quadrant. Then again, let me take one more angle in the second quadrant. I have taken 150 degree. Why I have taken 150 degree means for 30 degree, you know that for 30 degree cosecant will be 2. That is an integral value, not a fractional value. So, if you take 60 degree means sine 60 will be root 3 by 2 and hence cosecant x will be 2 by root 3. So, its value will be a fractional value. Therefore, let us take this 30 degree so that its cosecant value will be an integral value 2. So, what is that? Next one is 180 minus 30. I have taken 180 minus 30, that is 150. Because sine of 180 minus 30 will be, that is sine 150 is equal to sine of 180 minus 30. As the sine is positive in the second quadrant, it will be equal to again sine 30, that is 1 by 2. And hence cosecant will be again 2. So you have to choose the angle in such a way that you will get the integral values. Okay. So hence I have taken 150 degree and in radians it is equal to 5 pi by 6 and its value is 2. Again, let us come to the next 180 degree, which is pi, and its value is 0, and hence cosecant value is 1 by sine 0, that is 0, 1 by 0 is infinity, right? Then, let us take one angle in the third quadrant. Again, in the third quadrant, how we have taken 180 sine of 180 plus 30. Again, I have taken this 30 so that we get the integral value. So 180 plus 30 is nothing but sine 210. So that is equal to sine of 180 plus 30. But sine is negative in the third quadrant. So that is equal to minus sine 30, which is equal to minus 1 by 2. So what is the cosecant 210? It will be equal to minus 2, an integral value. Okay. Then 270, that is 3 pi by 2, sine 3 pi by 2 is so minus 1, and hence cosecant 3 pi by 2 is also equal to minus 1. Okay, then one angle in the fourth quadrant, I have taken 335 because sine of 2 pi, that is 360 minus 30 will be equal to sine 330, right? Sine of 360 minus 30 means it will be equal to minus sine 30, that is equal to minus 1 by 2. And hence its cosecant value is minus 2, an integral value. So you have to choose the angle in such a way that the values will be an integral value, so that it will be easy to mark, to plot the points, and hence to draw the graph. Okay. So that's why I have chosen the angle in such a way from 0 to 2 pi. And we have written the value of y, cosecant x here. And then let us see what would be the range. So using this range only, we are going to draw the graph. So once again, I am repeating this, right? Now, if you see this, if you mark down the values along a number line, look at here. For the angles in the first quadrant, 0 to 90 degree, that is 0 to pi by 2, the value, it is decreases from plus infinity to 1. So from infinity to 1, for all the angles in the first quadrant, the value of cosecant x decreases from infinity to 1, right? And then for the angles in the second quadrant, that is 19 to 180, it is again increasing, 1, 2 to infinity, increasing. So it is increasing in the second quadrant. For angles in the second quadrant, the value gets increased, cosecant gets increased, right? Then for 180 to 270, again here in infinity minus 2 minus 1. So even though it is infinity, and here to for 270 it is minus 1, and here for minus 1, you have to take that it is it has been increasing from minus infinity to minus 1. We cannot take it as plus infinity in this case, even though it is for pi, the value is infinity. Next value again here for another angle, it will be minus 2, and it has been increasing from negative side to minus 1. Therefore, you have to consider that for the angles in the third quadrant, it has been increasing from minus infinity to minus 1. So you shouldn't consider that plus infinity here, because from plus infinity doesn't goes to minus 1, crossing minus 2. So it should be from minus infinity to minus 1. For the angles in the third quadrant, the value has been increasing from minus infinity to minus 1. So from minus infinity to minus 1, it has been increasing. Okay. And then for the angles in the third quadrant, that is 270 to 360, you can see again it has been increasing from minus 1, minus 2. Even though at 270 it is infinity, you have to remember, you have to consider that the values have been increasing from minus 1, minus 2, etc. to minus infinity. Sorry, decreasing from minus 1, minus 2 to minus infinity. Therefore, for the angles in the fourth quadrant, the value of cosecant x decreases from minus 1 to minus infinity. Okay. Now, observing this, we can see that no value of cosecant x lies between minus 1 to plus 1. That is, the range of cosecant x doesn't lies in between minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. So, we have to exclude that values in between minus 1 to plus 1. So that's why what is the range of cosecant x? It can take the cosecant x have take any value except the values lies between minus 1 to plus 1. Therefore, what is the range? R minus open interval minus 1 comma 1. Or this can be expressed as this from minus infinity to minus 1 and plus 1 to infinity only the value exists. So we can also express that my infinity means always you have to use the open interval as the value is exactly not known. So minus infinity to minus 1, open at minus infinity and closed at minus 1, union this one, closed at 1 and open at infinity. Okay, so even you can rewrite this one as can be written like this, right? So this is the range, right? I have already explained in one of my previous video. Again, I am repeating this in order to draw the graph of the cosecant function. So, with the help of this, we are going to draw the graph of the cosecant function. Now, what is the domain? R minus n pi. So, at n pi, we cannot have the graph. Okay. So, for values of x at n pi, cosecant x doesn't exist. So, we cannot draw the graph at this point n pi. That means at 0. pi, 2 pi, 3 pi and minus pi, minus 2 pi, minus 3 pi, etc. The graph doesn't exist. So at these points, right? So if you have taken the x values, that is 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi, 5 pi by 2, 3 pi, such angles along the positive side, etc., etc. And again, minus pi by 2, minus pi, minus 3 by 2 along the negative side. And by taking the real values, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Along the positive y-axis and negative values along the negative y-axis. Now, let us see how we can plot the points and we can draw the graph. Now, for this n pi, the cosecant value does not exist. We have to exclude this n pi. At these values here, 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, the curve doesn't exist. And moreover, the value will be infinity and hence, the line at x is equal to pi, x is equal to 2 pi, 3 pi, 0, x is equal to minus pi drawn at these points will be vertical asymptotes to the graph. Okay. So, at these points, let us draw a line which meets the curve somewhere at infinity and these are called the vertical asymptotes as we have seen in the tangent function. Okay. In the tangent function, the vertical asymptotes are n is at x is equal to pi by 2. And minus pi by 2, 3 pi by 2 and so on. Here, the vertical asymptotes are at x is equal to pi, x is equal to 2 pi, 3 pi, 0, minus pi, etc. That is at x is equal to n pi, where n belongs to z. Now, for the angles in the first quadrant, that is 0 to 90, what would be that here for 2 pi by 630 degree 2 and for 90 degree 1. So 90 degree it is 1 and for somewhere at 30 degree it is 2 and again here again some other value it will be somewhere here and therefore if you join this you will get a U graph and it has touches at for 0 it will be infinity. Therefore the graph touches the line at x is equal to 0 will somewhere touch the graph at infinity and here the line at also for pi by 2 it is at pi the value will be infinity and hence the line drawn at x is equal to pi touches the graph somewhere at infinity. So this would be the graph, okay, and this interval 0 to pi, right? Then again from pi to 2 pi, second half. Now again pi to 2 pi, what would be the values here? At 270 it will be minus 3 pi, but minus 3 pi by 2 it is minus 1. So here minus 1 and somewhere the value will be minus 2 and minus 2 here. So again it is touches at minus infinity at x is equal to pi and x is equal to 2 pi. Look at here for from minus 1 to infinity it has been increasing and then decreasing and therefore it has been decreased, right? So pi to 2 pi. Likewise here you have to. And then you have to proceed like this. So the same pattern gets repeated. So and this is the graph of the cosecant function. Okay. See, while right finding the range, what we have seen here for the values of 0 to 90 degree, it has been decreasing. From infinity. Like look at here for 0 to pi by 2, the curve has been decreased. Right. It has been come like this decreased. And then for 90 to 180 degree, it has been increasing, right? So, it has been increasing. For 90 to 180, the curve has been increasing. And similarly, from 180 to 270, again, it has been decreasing from, increasing from minus infinity to minus 1. Therefore, from pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, it has been increasing. Again, for pi by 3 pi by 2 2 pi, the curve has been decreased. Therefore, here, look at, you can see the curve has been decreased. Okay, so, this is the graph of the cosecant function. Now, what do you observe from the graph of this cosecant function? What are the properties we can given? What are the properties of the cosecant function can be observed from this graph? Means, look at the graph. The graph is not continuous throughout. Okay, is it continuous? No, because there is a break at the line x is equal to 0 n pi, right, where n belongs to z and therefore the graph is not, the cosine function, cosecant function is not continuous throughout, but we can say that it is continuous in the given limited interval 0 to pi. In the limited interval 0 to pi it is continuous. Similarly in the limited interval pi to 2 pi it is continuous. Therefore we can say that it is continuous everywhere except. And then between 0 to 2 pi means we can say that we can, it is continuous except at the line x is equal to pi. So in within the short small intervals it is continuous but it is not continuous entirely. Okay. And then for 0 to 2 pi one complete revolution it is not, it is continuous everywhere but at except at the point x is equal to pi. Okay. In the open interval 0 to 2 pi. Now Also, you can see that it has neither maximum nor minimum. That means it is not like a wave-like pattern, and therefore it has neither maximum nor minimum. As it has neither maximum nor minimum, we cannot define the amplitude, because amplitude is nothing but the distance measured from the x-axis to its maximum or minimum, and therefore cosecant function has no amplitude. And then it is an odd function. And why it is, as sin x is an odd function, it is also an odd function. Look at this. If you interchange through, if you rotate this graph through 180 degree, again you will get the same pattern. And therefore, it is an odd function as it is symmetric about origin. Okay. And then what is the period of this function means? It is, it has a period 2 pi. Look here, from 0 to 2 pi, the pattern is like this, and the same pattern gets repeated again and again for another 2 pi, length 2 pi. Therefore, the period of the graph is 2 pi. And also, you know that a sine x is a periodic function with 2 pi, and hence cosecant x is also a periodic function with 2 pi. That is also true from the graph. So, these are the properties which has been observed for the cosecant function from the from its graph, okay. Now let us see inverse cosecant function. Now as in the previous cases, here also cosecant function is not 1 1, that is 1 1 and on to bijective in the entire domain r minus that n pi. Okay, so you have to choose the interval in such a way that the cosecant function is bijective. Now what is the domain, what is the domain for sine function in which it is pi bijective means? For sine function, we have taken the angles in the first quadrant and the fourth quadrant. That is, for sine function, we have taken the domain as from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So that in this domain, that is in these two quadrants, for the angles in the two quadrants, the sine value will never get repeated. And hence, we choose this domain as a principal domain for sine function to define the inverse sine. Okay. As sine cosecant x is a reciprocal of this sine function, here also to define the inverse cosecant function, again we are going to choose the same domain. Okay, this one, this interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, right? But is a little difference in here, because at 0, at this one, from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, we have to cross a value x is equal to 0 here. But at x is equal to 0, sine is not defined, and hence we cannot, sine x is 0, and hence cosecant x is not defined. So to get the inverse cosecant function, again we are going to choose the angles in the first quadrant and fourth quadrant, except this is 0. So what should be the domain? Domain should be the closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, except this 0. Okay, so this can also be written as from minus pi by 2 to 0, that is minus pi by 2 is included but 0 is excluded. So closed at minus pi by 2 and open at 0, union 0 comma pi by 2. Okay, so we can also rewrite like this, right? To understand this, again, for us, as cosecant is the inverse of sine function, again to define the inverse cosecant function, we are going to take the same first quadrant and fourth quadrant, the same domain as in the case of sine. But there we took the domain as minus pi by 2 closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. But for x is equal to 0, the sine is 0. Therefore, cosecant x is not defined. And therefore, to define the inverse cosecant function, we have to exclude the value 0. So, you have to take the domain like this. Okay. You can also rewrite that this domain like this. Right. So, how to define the cosecant function? The cosecant function is bijective in which interval? The closed at minus pi by 2 and open at 0, union open at 0 and closed at pi by 2 in this interval. Okay. So, we can define the cosecant function inverse as cosecant inverse from this domain to, as a, what is the cosecant inverse from minus infinity to minus 1, union 1 to infinity to this minus pi by 2, 0, union 0 to pi by 2, given by cosecant inverse of y is equal to, cosecant inverse of x is equal to y, if and only if cosecant y is equal to x, where this x belongs to this domain and y belongs to this range. Okay, so as usual, right? So how can we write this one? This is, can also be written as r minus, what is this domain, r minus open interval minus 1 comma 1, and this is nothing but closed interval minus 1 comma 1 minus the singleton 0. Okay. Now let us see what would be the graph of the inverse cosecant function. For that you can take the values of x and y. I have taken some integral, only three integral values to show the draw the graph. I have taken integral values plus 1, minus 1 and 2. We left 0 because at 0 cosecant does not exist. Therefore we cannot define, and leaving that 0 we have taken 1, plus 2 and minus 1. For 1, what would be the value of y? For angle pi by 2, its value will be 1, so it is pi by 2. And for 2, it should be pi by 6. Already we have seen this. And for minus pi by 2, it would be minus 1. Okay. So taking this along x-axis, what would be the values to be taken? From 0 to infinity here in the positive side, and from minus 1 to minus infinity along the negative side. And then angles along the y-axis, okay, 0, pi by 2. And as usual, at this y is equal to 0, y is equal to 2 pi, y is equal to pi, minus pi, minus 2 pi, etc. It doesn't exist. Therefore, if you draw lines at this, this would be the horizontal asymptotes to the curve, to the inverse cosecant function. And then for pi by 2, for x is equal to 1, the value of y is pi by 2. For x is equal to 1, the value is pi by 2. And for x is equal to 2, pi by 6, somewhere here pi by 6. And for minus 2, it would be, so by like this, if you draw, you will get a graph like this. Okay. So this would be the graph of the inverse cosecant function. And then you can see that from this graph, look at this, here from within minus 1 to 1, it doesn't exist. Okay. From minus 1 to 1, it doesn't exist. The value of x does not exist from minus 1 to 1. And similarly, for the angle, between minus 1 to 1, it does not exist. And therefore, what is the principal domain of the cosecant function? The closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 minus singleton 0, or minus pi by 2 closed at minus pi by 2 and open at 0, union open at 0 and closed at plus pi by 2. And this is called the, this restricted domain is called the principal domain of the cosecant function. Okay.